Mr. Speaker, the Labor Party was formed on the basis that the value and contribution of workers to the economy needs to be recognised. Our guiding beliefs are about the value of work, a fair day's pay for a fair day's work. But more than that, Labor recognises that in work lies things that are of great significance to New Zealanders, to their self-esteem, to their ability to provide for their families and care for their families, and to their contribution to society. Work, jobs, good, safe jobs are at the heart of Labor's vision for the society that we want to live in. Jobs and work are at the heart of our policy, which is why that it gives Labor and me no comfort whatsoever to learn today that 153,000 New Zealanders are out of work, unemployed. We have no pleasure that in the last 3 months, 5,000 jobs have been lost. And Mr. Speaker, these are not just statistics. These are real people with families to look after, mortgages to pay, who are losing their jobs. From Dunedin to Dannevirke, from Nelson to Napier, jobs are being lost and families' lives are being put at risk. And these real stories range right across the age groups. From the young graduate who's come to see me, 8 months after graduating, 100 applications for jobs, no job, does not know what to do with his future. Or to the gentleman from Christchurch who I found sticking under the door of my electorate office his CV, having also applied for nearly 100 jobs since leaving Christchurch to come to Wellington. And those jobs are not there for those people, Mr. Speaker. New Zealanders have given the National Party the benefit of the doubt, the global financial crisis, the Christchurch earthquakes. But now, Mr. Speaker, is the time when New Zealanders should be seeing some hope from this government that things will get better on the job front. And instead, Mr. Speaker, all there is fear that they will lose their job. And in actual fact, it is the earthquake and the recovery, rather, from the earthquake that's now propping up the job market. It's no longer possible for this government to use the excuse of the earthquake. It is meant to be helping with the recovery. And it is no longer right, Mr. Speaker, for this government to continue to blame the global financial crisis nearly 5 years after they took office. They promised New Zealanders 170,000 new jobs. They will fall woefully short of that mark. In the last 2 years, only 17,000 jobs have been created. That's across 2 whole years. That is simply not enough from this government. And imagine just how much worse it would be if 200,000 Kiwis hadn't taken flight to Australia. Unemployment would be well over 8%. So, Mr. Speaker, what does a proper jobs policy look like? From Labor, what it will mean is giving exporters a fair go, getting R&D going, making sure that training of workers is a priority, giving Kiwi companies a proper go at government contracts, and real regional development policies that focus on industries where there is growth, in manufacturing, in ICT, not the National Party's approach of the search for a silver bullet that simply cannot be found. Mr. Speaker, it is only with Labor that that change to a real jobs policy will happen. I want to finish with an old saying to try to give comfort to some people who are out there looking for work. They say a recession is when someone you know loses their job, a depression is when you lose your job, and a recovery starts when John Key loses his.
Honourable Tim Goodacre.
Mr. Speaker, the events that have unfurled with respect to potentially contaminated infant formula over the last